This section hones in on a famous trilemma of distributed systems called the CAP theorem. The most reasonable explanation for the name CAP theorem is that the researcher who came up with it, Eric Brewer, was wearing a cap to cover his bald spot upon discovering this trilemma. A less plausible but more popular theory is that CAP stands for the three components of the trilemma: consistency, availability, and partition tolerance. These are not three random words, nor are they disconnected from the previous section about safety, liveness, and consensus correctness. After defining these terms and proving the CAP theorem, we'll delve into the implications. The C in CAP stands for consistency. Consistency in a system is defined as every node providing the most recent state of a system. If it does not have the most recent state, it will not provide any response. This, as you can tell, builds off the idea of safety because it refers to something that will never happen. Consistency in a system says that no two nodes will return a different state at any given time, and that no node will return an outdated state. The A in CAP stands for availability. Availability in a system means that every node has constant read and write access. In other words, an available system allows me to make updates and retrieve the state of the system without delay. This, then, is born from liveness. Availability promises what must happen, which is the ability to read or write some state. And last but not least, the P in CAP stands for partition tolerance. A quick definition: a partition is an inability for two nodes or more nodes in a network to communicate with each other. If node A cannot receive messages from node B and vice versa, this means that there is a partition between the two. You can consider partitions to be the equivalent of unbounded network latency, meaning that messages will not get to the recipient. Partition tolerance, then, is the ability to function in spite of partitions within the network. Partition tolerance is more difficult to categorize, but it also falls in line with safety, as it specifies what will not happen. Partition tolerance states that a network will not stop functioning, even with partitions. So what is the CAP theorem truly? It's a simple statement. A system can only have two out of these three properties at any given time. The choice must be made between consistency, availability, and partition tolerance. You see this intersection of these three right here? This is what we like to call a magical fantasy land. Decades ago, when distributed systems were still new in academia, several researchers and organizations claimed that they had created systems which had all three properties. We'll give you a quick proof in just a few seconds as to why CAP theorem is true. In order to prove the CAP theorem, let's run through some examples. In each example, we're going to be giving an example of a situation in which choosing two properties forces us to yield the third. Let's pretend this is a database which stores my favorite color. In our first example, let's choose partition tolerance and availability. Here's how we lose consistency. Let's say it's the end of my senior year. I'm graduating from Berkeley, but I get accepted into a graduate program at Stanford. Naturally, my favorite color will have changed from blue to red. I send the update to the system, and my message happens to go to node 1. Node 1 relays the update to all other accessible nodes, which update their state. Node 2 and 4, however, cannot receive messages from the other half, so they're not aware of the update. I later query node 2 for my favorite color. Node 2, according to our choice of availability, will return its current state. However, this is not the most recent state, as the most recent update was red. Because node 2 provided a state that was not the most recent, it was not consistent. Let's try another configuration, particularly partition tolerance and consistency. We'll see how that ends up sacrificing availability. So, same scenario. I send the update to node 1, which then sends the update to all the other nodes. Nodes 2 and 4 are still ignorant of the update to red. Again, I query node 2. So what happens this time? Since node 2 is bound to consistency, it chooses not to return anything. The bad news is we get no information, but the good news is we get no outdated information. If you're wondering how node 2 knows it's outdated, we can say that it first asks all other nodes for updates before returning a state. If it cannot receive messages from all nodes, it will assume it has outdated information and refuse to return a value. we lose out on something in the last two examples. So let's see what happens when we choose consistency and availability. I send an update to node 1. Node 1 passes the information around. I query node 2 and it returns a value to me. Great, everything worked as expected. Except there's one problem. If we throw in a partition, this wouldn't work. If we throw in a partition, we're forced into one of the first two situations. And this proof demonstrates the spirit of the CAP theorem, that a system must compromise. So now that you understand the CAP theorem, you'll often hear discussion about consistency and availability in consensus algorithm discussion. However, there are a few notes to include in your takeaways of this lecture that will let you better appreciate the CAP theorem's significance and implications. First, although our proof used extremes, these three properties are not black and white. Instead, they're a spectrum. For example, instead of never returning a value to stay consistent but give up all availability, a node might wait 5 or 10 seconds before giving in and returning some value. In addition, there might not be unbreakable partitions in your system, but network latency may cause state discrepancies. Instead of discussing the CAP theorem in absolutes, we consider compromises. In addition, almost every reasonable system will assume that partitions are going to occur in the system, meaning that the choice of P as one of the two properties is given. For this reason, the CAP theorem often reduces to a dilemma between consistency and availability. The choice is whether it is preferable for the system to return a false or outdated value, or to simply not return a value at all. On this choice hinges all the implications of the CAP theorem. Lastly, many in the blockchain space will take the CAP theorem too seriously. Because many don't have the formal distributed systems background, some incorrectly fixate on the black and white implication of the CAP theorem rather than using it as another lens to view the system's design.